Breakfast with Spaniels with Dr. Judy Morgan.
Show today? You can talk? Would you like to have a discussion? Who's that?
All of Dr. Morgan's products at her website at www.drjudymorgan.com. Now it's time to sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Welcome to Breakfast with Spaniels with Dr.
Start again.
Judy Morgan.
Morning. Okay. That was Gabby. Gabby wanted to say hi this morning. So, silly me, I haven't been online very much in the past week and a half. You all know why, because moving has been a little crazy. But a lot of times when Hugh is driving, I'll turn my phone on and sometimes I scroll through Facebook. And someone had asked the question of at what age they should neuter their cavalier puppy. So neutering a boy. And, you know, dumb me, I answered and said never. And oh my gosh, the backlash was ridiculous. And one woman in particular just berated me for days. And I said, well, sorry, I answered that question. Never mind. And she said, I want proof. I want scientific studies. Where are they? You know, you can't post that without posting scientific studies. And I'm like, I don't have time right now, lady. Back off. Interestingly enough, in my veterinary practice news that came a couple days ago, here's the title. Neutering, the risks and benefits in the context of breed, sex, and age. So sit back, relax, because I'm going to read you a story. A perennial subject of debate and controversy in veterinary medicine is the age at which dogs and cats should be neutered, and even if they should be neutered at all. I looked at the evidence concerning this question in the April 2020 issue and concluded there is no simple universal rule to be followed. Now, this is written by Brennan McKenzie, who studies evidence-based medicine. So he basically looks at all the different studies, all the evidence that we have, and then comes to conclusions based on evidence, which is a great way to do things, which this person was asking me for evidence. And I said, it's out there. You just have to look for it. And I don't have time right now. So yay, this came out. All right. The most important conclusion to be drawn from the research concerning health effects of neutering at various ages is that the only appropriate response to a client's question, when should I neuter, is it depends. And that's my answer to a lot of things, because there is no one size fits all for anything. There may be advantages to both early and delayed neutering, as well as to not neutering at all. And these will vary with sex, age, and breed. It is probably a fair generalization that delaying neutering in large breed dogs until full growth, 1 to 2 years of age, depending on the breed, may have some health advantages, especially in females. And this woman went off on me and said that all females needed to be spayed at 6 months, blah, blah, blah. And she gave her old-fashioned mythical reasons that we have believed for many years that are wrong. It may even be appropriate not to neuter male large breed dogs at all, at least from the perspective of the impact on the risk of common health conditions. In smaller breeds, there seems to be less compelling reason for delaying neutering beyond the rather arbitrary traditional age. However, there's also the potential for increased health risks with every choice. Delaying neutering or leaving animals intact will raise some risks while reducing others, and the optimal outcome for any individual will never be predictable. One major study of the health effects of neutering has since been published that purports to help veterinarians individualize neutering recommendations for dogs based on the patient's breed and sex. The study adds valuable information to the complex subject. It also contains significant limitations that need to be considered when integrating this evidence into specific recommendations. Though the authors have created a convenient table with suggested neutering recommendations for particular breeds, there are numerous caveats, and it would be a mistake to follow these guidelines uncritically. So there's a really nice table here based on breed, age, and whether it's a girl or a boy. And I will write a blog on this, hopefully this week. Okay. So the study involved looking back at the medical records of dogs seen at the University of California, UC Davis Veterinary Teaching Hospital. So thankfully, they actually used a teaching hospital. Dogs from 35 breeds participated, and the occurrence of specific medical conditions thought to be influenced by neutering were identified. These included joint disorder, hip dysplasia, elbow dysplasia, cranial cruciate ligament rupture, certain cancers, mast cell, lymphoma, osteosarcoma, hemangiosarcoma, and mammary cancer in females, and miscellaneous disorders such as urinary incontinence and pyometra in females, which is infection of the uterus, and intervertebral disc disease and dachshunds and corgis. The ages at which subjects were neutered were grouped into categories: before 6 months, 6 to 11 months, 12 to 23 months, or 24 months to 8 years. The term early neutering was defined as neutering before 12 months of age. Different breeds were analyzed independently, although there are some general comments about differences between small, large, and giant breeds. Statistical analysis was done to compare the occurrence of the medical conditions of interest between males and females, intact and neutered dogs, and dogs neutered at different ages. If statistically significant differences were found, or if there were differences they felt had reached significance with a larger sample, the authors used these to inform recommendations about whether to neuter male and female dogs of each breed studied and at what age to neuter. In general, the findings suggest most small breed dogs have less risk of joint disorders and that neutering doesn't necessarily affect this, regardless of the age at which it's performed. Cancer risk is also low in most small breeds and typically not affected by neutering, though there are a few specific breeds that are exceptions. For example, the Shih Tzu. Gee, I hope he tells us what with the Shih Tzu. For larger breeds, there did seem to be an increase in joint disorders and cancers with neutering and a greater effect of neutering at a younger age. However, this finding was not consistent between breeds or between sexes within a breed. Even closely related breeds, such as Golden Retrievers and Labrador Retrievers, showed different patterns, which suggests the role of genetics may often swamp the effects of neutering. While this is a useful and interesting study, it includes significant limitations that prohibit confidently generalizing these data to make universal neutering recommendations. The study population was that of an academic referral hospital. It likely differs in many ways from dogs presenting in general practice. I think Banfield, because they have a large database, has done some of this study work as well. The breeds, husbandry practices, and resources of owners, the general medical care received, and many other factors differ between dogs seen in primary care practice and at the university, which is true. And these differences likely impact disease risk. The study population was also limited geographically and excluded many breeds and mixed breed dogs. So the applicability of the findings to other populations is unclear. Okay. They also only evaluated dogs up to 8 years of age. Many of the conditions studied, including joint disorders and cancer, increase in frequency with age. And as dogs from many of the breeds studied routinely live into their mid to late teens, the occurrence of much relevant disease was likely missed in the study. Whether the effects of neutering on these diseases would appear different if older subjects were studied is unknown. Furthermore, one of the most important variables of interest to veterinarians and pet owners is lifespan, and this was not evaluated in the study, which it would have been good if it was. There is evidence neutered animals may live longer than those left intact, but we don't have good studies on that yet. And that may be partly because neutered males are less likely to roam, get hit by car, attacked by other dogs, that sort of less likely to fight, that sort of thing. So it may not be just health related as much as behavioral related. Even if the incidence of some diseases such as cancer or joint disorders is increased following neutering, if overall longevity is greater, this would obviously influence the decision making of owners. Okay, so the chart that he has for males, there's a bunch of breeds listed here, but for, I would say 90% of them, it's your choice whether to neuter or not neuter. Dogs that he says should be left intact, the only one in that category that he categorically says should be left intact are Dobermans. Really interesting. Beyond 6 months should be Cocker, Corgi, and Lab. Beyond 11 months should be Beagle, Border Collie, Boston, Golden, Miniature Poodle, and Roddy. And beyond 23 months, Bernese Mountain Dog, Boxer, German Shepherd, Irish Wolfhound, and Standard Poodle. Those large breed dogs are the ones that are more commonly affected by some of the really aggressive cancers. And so we are showing a protective effect by leaving them intact for the females. 90% of those, they say it's your choice whether or not to spay. Beyond 6 months, he has Australian cattle dog, Rottweiler, and St. Bernard. Boy, I would put those out a lot further. Beyond 11 months, they have Border Collie, Collie, English Springer Spaniel, Labrador Retriever, and beyond 23 months, Boxer, Cocker Spaniel, Doberman, German Shepherd, Shetland Sheepdog, and Shih Tzu. That's really interesting. I have to delve into why the Shih Tzus should be left intact and what is their risk. There's something weird about Shih Tzus. This really supports what I said. It silly me commented on that post that we arbitrarily set spay and neuter at 6 months of age many years ago. I mean, it was that when I was in school back in the early 80s. That was arbitrary. It was really a convenience thing for pet owners who didn't want to have to put up with their females going into heat. And we didn't want to risk, I think pet owners have become a lot more responsible, but we, you know, didn't want to risk those unwanted pregnancies in young dogs under 12 months of age. So, yeah, if you don't want to hear opinions that aren't in line with what you believe, don't ask. Exactly. So this person who wanted proof, well, you know, here's a great retrospective study. I doubt she watches my page. I don't remember her name. I don't even remember what page that comment was on. So it doesn't matter. But, you know, if you're going to hassle me long enough, I'll come up with an answer. But anyway, so that's your education for today. I've got a list of things here that I want to talk about. I think it's ridiculous to argue with Judy Morgan on a page titled Friends Who Like Judy Morgan. It wasn't on that page, but I think it was on maybe the Healthy Cavalier or something. I don't remember. It might have been just another holistic site. I don't know. It's whatever popped up on my phone at the moment. I think somebody may have mentioned my name, which is why I got tagged or something. But anyway, you can argue with me. I'm open to discussion. But, you know, 36 years of doing this and reading the research and seeing what's out there, I've seen a lot of stuff go by. Anyway, so, okay, everybody have a wonderful day. Let me see if I can get music. Of course, it's going to be the wrong music, but that's okay. It's music nonetheless. Everybody have a wonderful day. Got cats and dogs fed. Still have to go to the barn. Have to start working on consultations. Got a bunch tomorrow. Back to work. Discussion and arguing are different. I agree, Teresa. I don't mind having a discussion. This woman was getting ruder with every comment, though. It wasn't Healthy Cavaliers. Thanks, Jane. Yeah, I forget what it was. I think it was some other holistic site. I don't know. Ah, your husband's having the Moz procedure on his forehead like you. That healed beautifully. They had to renumb his like 3 times because they kept having to go further and further, but it's healed and it looks really good. And he only complained for 2-3 days. And then I took his stitches out. So he just needed to take Tylenol. He had a headache.
Remember, you can purchase all of Dr. Morgan's products at
okay.
her website.
Everybody have
drjudymorgan.com.
Everybody have a wonderful day and we'll see you tomorrow.